Ladies and gentlemen, we are 6 nights away from the end of Season 3 and WrestleMania 3. Welcome to the last draw of Season 3. It is Dave Easton alongside the Housewives favourite, Maz Freeway. Maz, good evening.
Good evening, Dave.
Are you ready to go, Maz? The last time of Season 4, we are ready to... Season 3 even, Season 4 round the corner. See, I'm even not too excited for Season 4, Maz.
Yeah, Burrell's last stop before WrestleMania 3. Here we go. It's going to be a great night of action.
Yeah, ladies and gentlemen, we are ready to go. Some big news coming up, and here comes the GM.
Let's see what Mr. Perfect has in store. What's he going to have set up for WrestleMania this year?
Yeah, we still don't know what the main event is at WrestleMania this year for the Raw side. And of course, we have heard of a main event booked for tonight, but let's see what Mr. Perfect has to say.
I'm sure Luke Benward is definitely going to be looking to get his rematch. I think after last week and Zaylin just kind of interrupting that matchup is going to definitely fuel Benward to get another rematch.
Look at this now, Mr. Perfect scene here. Of course, thanking everyone who stuck by us during the season. And now, well, he has booked the main event. What is the main event going to be? Let's find out. Yeah, tonight... Oh my god, Matt Rhodes against AJ Z against Luke Benward and Zadler. Oh my god, a fatal four-way, Maz, for the title.
Who's going to walk out WrestleMania 3 with the championship and go into Season 4?
Who is going to be this champion indeed going into Season 4? And tonight, all four men will be in the main event. Of course, tag team action. It is going to be AJ Z and Luke Benward taking on Matt Rhodes and Zadlan here tonight. What a main event that's going to be. And what a show we have got ready for you guys. Mr. Perfect once again pulling out all the stops. And what a main event for WrestleMania. Coming up first, ladies and gentlemen, we're going to kick... Yeah, gonna kick things off with the realest guys. Gonna take on Ryan Fox and Killer Whale.
Our last chance we'll see about Jabroni Diaz and X-Con.
Ladies and gentlemen, making their way to the ring. Here they come, the realest guys. You're soft, you slop.
They call me pop. Looks like they can pick up a big win here tonight, and maybe they'll have a chance of getting into Season 4, but I seriously doubt it.
Big one. Doesn't look in a happy mood here tonight.
What would you be if you had to come out following this goofball in front?
Hey, the fans love him, and I think that's what most people care about here tonight. This guy, these two more popular than ever.
I'm sure the DL Express of Ryan Fox and Killer Whale was going to come out here and show these two guys what tag team wrestling is all about.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, introducing their opponents, being led to the ring by Mr. Joe Disney. Introducing first, he is Ryan Fox.
And Ryan Fox, one of the most decorated men in the Disney Alliance. He's held the world championship multiple times, and I'm sure just about a matter of time before him and Killer Whale pick up a tag team championship win.
You have to see Season 4 maybe on the horizon for these two, but well, what a way to go out. The realest guys can pick up the win here tonight. Ryan Fox, ready to go, ladies and gentlemen. Here tonight on Raw, the last Raw of Season 3, 40 episodes, and what a way to kick things off with the three-time World Heavyweight Champion.
Yeah, look to show that the Disney Alliance is still one of the best here in NSW and looking to power on through to Season 4.
Look at Ryan Fox, always, what do you call him, arrogant, Maz?
Yeah, possibly, very cocky, very egotistical.
And what about this? Ladies and gentlemen, his tag team partner, Killer Whale!
What can you say about this man? He's huge, he is massive, he is hungry to take on any competitors in the ring and looking to squash Ali Jabroni here tonight.
What a way to kick things off, ladies and gentlemen. We ask that you get on social media as always. Tell everybody where we are. They don't want to miss this. What the last stop for Raw before WrestleMania 3 this Sunday night. And well, you can just tell by the crowd here, they are going to be into this. We have so much to look forward to tonight. And we are going to kick things off hot and heavy with tag team action. The realest guys have, well, could you see a mountain to climb, Maz?
Most definitely with these two competitors here with the Disney Alliance are definitely great competitors, and they're going to show that this is why tag team division on Raw is so much better.
Let's find out. Let's get things going. First match of the night is about to start. Here we go then. Maz, do I even have to ask you who you think's going to win?
Gotta stay with the Disney, man. Disney's always got his team ready to go.
See what happens here. Let's see what the NSW app has to say about it. Very close. 53.9 for Ryan Fox and Killer Whale. 46.1 for the realest guys. And Ryan Fox starting things off for the Disney. Well, what can you call them now? Can you call them the DL Express? There's been so many of them. Just as I say that, Giovanni coming back with a lovely spinning neckbreaker.
From what I heard from Mr. Disney backstage, he said that any member that tags up here for the Disney Alliance, they're part of the Disney, the Disneyland Express, and we'll have to see if they can make a statement here tonight.
Indeed. What will tonight bring? We have an Internet Championship match, the final one of the season, and we also have a number one contendership match. Who's going to face the Hounds at WrestleMania, of course? It's either going to be One Sec or the Flock here tonight. Giovanni now working over on Ryan Fox. And what? Oh, hold on. Who's this? Oh, Sophia. He means it can only mean one thing.
Yeah, there's Mike, and gotta be expecting the world champion to be showing up here tonight.
Yep, there he is, ladies and gentlemen. Matt Rhodes, the World Heavyweight Champion, in the building. And, well, does he even know that he's got a fatal four-way to come this Sunday night for the World Heavyweight Championship?
He's got about a 25% chance of holding on to that title come WrestleMania. If he's not aware of it, it's definitely going to raise the ire of him tonight.
And look at this, inside the ring. Oh, look at the strength by one-handed! Come on, ref, turn around!
I'm impressed that Juan was able to get that much weight up in the air like that, but Big Killer Whale still got a little bit left in him.
Yeah, into the cover. Disney up again, distracting the referee. Fox should be in here. And now, nope, Fox doing enough here to get Killer Whale back in control. Oh, the big splash into the corner! Referee trying to tell Disney to calm down or he might be out of here. And uh-oh. Here comes the wave.
Big splashdown.
Yep. There it is. Thanks for coming, Juan Diaz. Into the cover. Hook of the leg. Thanks for coming. There's the three. And the Disney Alliance pick up the win.
Can't wait to see what the Disney Alliance will have in store for us come season four. A big win for Ryan Fox and Killer Whale here tonight.
Ladies and gentlemen, the winners of this contest, the team of Ryan Fox and Killer Whale.
So like I said, don't bet against the Disney Alliance. They're definitely a force to be reckoned with here in NSW, and I'm sure they're going to be something bigger and better come season four.
And well, you've got to think that is a big win tonight. Will we see plenty of them in tag team action? I'm sure we will as the season continues. And uh-oh. Trouble lies ahead. Of course, Zadlan, of course, will be going for the World Heavyweight title on Sunday night. But Maz, the other question I need to ask here is, does Zadlan have more Luke Benoit on his mind than the World Heavyweight title?
Well, this Fatal 4-Way is definitely matching up to be like two of the best rivalries in NSW, being put on the major showcase here in NSW is WrestleMania 3. And you mean you got Luke Benoit that has a major rivalry with Zadlan, and Matt and AJZ definitely have their storied past, so we'll have to see how that folds out at WrestleMania.
And look at this. Damon Steele saying, Matt Rhodes, do not play the hero tonight. Let Zadlan do the work. I don't think Matt Rhodes is going to take this lying down, to be honest.
Yeah, can these two guys coexist together to take on Ben Ward and AJZ? Or can AJZ and Ben Ward coexist together?
Well, you have to say it. We were going to find out in the weeks to come, because coming up next, ladies and gentlemen, the Internet Championship is on the line as Kevin King defends against Big Bad Brody Lee.
If the fans waited for it, the fans want to see Brody Lee and Kevin King and Big Bad Brody Lee going at it here tonight.
Ladies and gentlemen, introducing first, he is your reigning defending Internet Champion, Kevin King!
What will the King have in store tonight? Will he be able to hold on to his internet title to go into season 4 with it? Or will we see Brody Lee taking it away from him here tonight?
Kevin King. Who would have thought, Maz, that he would have been at this stage with the internet title, of course? What a season Kevin King has had.
Yeah, he started out going for the heavyweight title, ended up winning that. Was a great heavyweight champion, and now the fans have voted him one of the best here in NSW and wanted him to go for that internet title, and took it off of the former champ, Double J, which we haven't seen since.
Maz, the King has definitely got a mountain to climb here tonight.
But with all of his fans here to worship in the King's greatness, I'm sure that'll help him propel him to win this, or hold on to this title here tonight.
Here we go, ladies and gentlemen. We're going to go. The King ready for action, as always, here tonight on Raw. And ladies and gentlemen, his opponent, he is Big Bad Brody Lee.
Him and Sean have really done really great here in NSW in season 3, and what a great debut it was seeing Brody Lee appear here in NSW. And now let's see what he can do here in this matchup. Maybe he can pick up the internet title and take it into season 4.
It could be, yeah, it could be. This could be the time, really, that Brody Lee really fulfills what many people said. You see, be very surprised that Brody Lee has not won a championship this season. Could he do it on the last show before the end of season 3?
Yeah, we'll have to see. I think this could be his chance. I think Kevin King's a really good competitor, but Brody Lee might just be that much better.
Well, Brody Lee, here we go, ladies and gentlemen. Kevin King, Brody Lee, ready to go. As the motorbike is taken away, you can hear in the background. Both these competitors are ready to go for the Internet Championship. Let's see what Maz has to say about this one.
I'm going to go with the upset. I'm going to go with Brody Lee. I think he's going to look to really capitalize on this chance here tonight and walk out of Season 3 with the Internet Championship going into Season 4.
Wow, let's see what the NSW... 87.6 for Kevin King, 12.4 for Brody Lee. It doesn't look like they're having your sort of... confidence, Maz, in this one.
No, but I always try to root for some of the underdogs in here in NSW, and hope to see if the King can live up to the hype of the fans.
Look at this nice scoop again, and look how Snake Eyes are the second time on the champ. And a back suplex, and of course, not many people could match up with Kevin King for the power here, Maz, but Brody Lee, definitely one of them people.
He's got the height, and definitely he's got the power with him, and him and Kevin King definitely match up in that power area, but I think with the height advantage, that's going to give Brody Lee the advantage in this match.
Look at this now. Look out. Suplex! Almost taking Brody Lee out of his boots. And look at this. The punches. The devastating effect that Kevin King has. Brody Lee having no answer to it early on here.
Kevin King with those southpaw punches, throwing those big lefts and taking down the big guy, but Brody Lee's back up and unfazed by it.
Look at this, a nice block, and another punch just sends Brody Lee down. And really, this is Kevin King's advantage here. Them punches have just really devastating and stunning Brody Lee here early on in this contest. The champ in control again, and you can see it every opportunity, Maz. Kevin King going for these punches right into the midriff, and really it is stunning Brody Lee early on here.
And he's trying to wear him down with those big punches to the midsection, but oh no, Brody Lee is still unable to find a way to counteract the King here so far.
Yeah, you've got to think, ah, oh, there's one lovely big backdrop, and now the punches of his own, and Brody Lee, the one thing you don't want to do, Maz, in this is get Brody Lee obviously angry, and punching him like that is going to, yeah, it may wound him, but it's going to really rile the guy up.
Yeah, you don't want to stand toe-to-toe with him. He's definitely going to be able to back up those punches from Kevin King with his own.
Now, pick up, and then the burst, oh, right between the eyes! And that could do it, you know, Maz. One false move, no fighting spirit by Kevin King. I know, but look at this. Brody Lee caught him. And now...
Yeah, he's trying to stifle that fighting spirit that Kevin King was trying to get back. And
oh, no. Jackknife! Powerbomb! The crowd can sense it. I think Kevin King's reign is not going to last too long. Cover! And he got him!
A big win for Brody Lee to finish off season 3.
Wow. Ladies and gentlemen, the winner of this contest, a new internet champion, Brody Lee.
What a killer matchup between two big guys here in NSW. And Brody Lee was able to capture his first title here in the internet championship. I can't wait to see what happens next season for Brody Lee.
Got to give credit to Brody Lee in this one. He is your new internet champion, and we'll take it on to season 4. Well, what about this, Maz? What about this guy? AJZ, big match tonight, and of course, Sunday night, he could end season 3 as the World Heavyweight Champion.
Yeah, what a great coup for Disney will that be if AJZ is able to pick up the victory.
Could happen. Of course, Disney would love nothing more to end the season with the title, of course. Well, I'm sure he'll be with AJZ at ringside for the main event tonight.
Let's see if Disney will get involved in that matchup or will he stay out of it.
Well, you never know. Ladies and gentlemen, coming up next, 6-man tag team action as Bobby Hall and Team Canada take on the New Day.
The Keller family taking on the New Day. This is going to be a great matchup between two great factions here in NSW.
Ladies and gentlemen, introducing first the team of TJ Carter and Canadian Tom, Team Canada.
And we'll have to see if Team Canada can pick it up next season and move up in the tag team rankings and maybe get a shot at the tag team championships. Didn't really have much of a chance this season, but it's always next season.
Of course, we just have a bit of a quick question just before, Maz. I didn't miss it out. I do apologize. I'll try and go back in the NSW. It was actually, what does Brody Lee have to do to pull the upset? But we've just seen the answer to that.
It's use his power game like he did. Use his strength and overpower Kevin King and hit that power bomb, and that was about it.
Ladies and gentlemen, their tag team partner, he is the number one contender for the United States Championship, Bobby Hall.
Everyone thought this season would be Bobby Hall's breakout season, but we'll have to see if maybe season 4 will be much better for him.
Don't get us wrong, Bobby Hall has had hardcore success, But can he get the United States Championship?
It's very possible. I mean, he's definitely looked good this season, and he's definitely improved, but we'll have to see if maybe season four will be his turnaround. Maybe we'll see him vying for a championship here and there.
Bobby Hall ready to team up with Team Canada in this one, trying to make Travis Keller proud on the last row of season three. Ladies and gentlemen, their opponents, the team of Big E Langston, Xavier Woods, and Kofi Kingston, the new day!
Yeah, it's time to feel the power of the new day, and we'll have to see if they can pick up the big winner tonight to move on to into season four with a big win under their belt, going into possible championship title match next season.
We really need to get these goofs are still together. I don't understand how.
Well, they were former tag team champions, and they definitely look to try and get back there. They had a little stutter step last week against One Sec, wasn't able to cash in on that number one contendership match, and hopefully here tonight they'll get the big win and go on to season four and possibly win the tag team titles.
Well, we'll have to think, but it's going to be a very interesting six-man tag team match coming up next right here on Raw, the last Raw, as you say, before WrestleMania. Remember, WrestleMania comes your way this Sunday night at 9:30 in the UK. Check your local times. Of course, the pre-show, 9:30. Main show starts at 10 o'clock. Do not miss it, of course. More information coming up during the show. Here we go then. Maz, who are you going for in this one?
I'm going to go with the New Day. I think they're the better tag team here in this matchup so far, and we'll have to see if they can pick up the big win to go into season four with a win.
See what the NSWR has to say. 56% for the New Day, 44% for Bobby Hall and Team Canada. And oh my goodness, Big E Langston taken into the ring post by Canadian Tom. And then TJ Carter getting involved as well. And already, New Day in a lot of trouble here, Maz.
Yep, and Xavier's over there getting distracting TJ Carter for a little bit there to let Big E get the advantage.
Yeah, but is he the lead? I don't even think he's the... No, yes, he is the legal man. I thought for a minute there that he wasn't a legal man, but he is. Here comes Kofi into the ring. TJ Carter on his side of the ring, letting Bobby Hall. Bobby Hall, of course, is an MVP for the United States title at WrestleMania this Sunday. And look out, suplex!
We'll have to see if Bobby Hall can show what he's got looking forward to in this matchup here against Kofi so far.
Yeah, look at this, Kofi going down, bit of a glancing blow that. And then Hall hanging on. Kofi, what's he going to do here? Drop kick to the outside. Watch Kingston now, what's he going to do here? Looked like he was going to come back, go and fly over the ropes, but thought better of it. Nice arm drag. Maz, you've got to think in this one, the New Day, really, do you think New Day have the advantage in this one with them being more of a group?
Well, yeah, there's definitely a cohesiveness between the New Day. I know Bobby Hall's teamed with Team Canada every now and then, but I don't know if they have as much cohesiveness as New Day does, since they've been together for a long while now.
Xavier Woods in along with Canadian Tom. Canadian Tom going straight after Big E Langston. Langston hits the announce table right in front of us, but this is really give Xavier Woods the chance to really capitalize here, and takes down Canadian Tom with a huge clothesline. Referee quick across the cover and a kick at it too.
It seemed Canadian Tom was not happy with the dancing of Big E Langston over there and decided to take it upon himself to go and attack him.
Three! Got him! Wow, I didn't even think that was happening, but the New Day picked the win up here tonight and Canadian Tom is defeated.
Oh, what? Big win for New Day, and hopefully next season they'll get the chance to pick up the tag team championships again.
Ladies and gentlemen, the winners of this contest, the team of Xavier Woods, Big E Langston, and Kofi Kingston, the New Day!
Seems the fans are right. New Day does rock. Big win here tonight for the New Day.
Where are you even seeing the New Day rock? You know they don't rock. Ladies and gentlemen, remember, we are into the last week of Season 3. After tonight, you have Total Divas, ECW, SmackDown, and then TakeOver 7 on Saturday night. Then the big one, WrestleMania 3. Show start 11 o'clock in the UK, 7 in the East, 4 in the West for this week only. Social media, Nonstop Wrestling UK is our YouTube, NSW underscore 360 is Twitter, and it's Facebook 365. Coming up next, what about this singles action as Rob Dundee takes on the monster Tim Rage?
Let's see if Dundee has what it takes to take down the big monster in Tim Rage.
Ladies and gentlemen, introducing first, being accompanied to the ring by his head of security, Geordie from Scotland, he is Rob Dundee.
Yeah, what a chance Rob Dundee had last week. Wasn't able to completely win that matchup, but we'll have to see if he can take down Tim Rage here tonight and go out with a big win on Season 3.
Well, you have to think, Dundee, really, is Dundee in holiday mode, would you say, Maz? Not really been hitting the heights many people thought he would.
Yeah, we'll have to see if maybe this will be the match where he can show that he can be a dominant force for next season.
Ladies and gentlemen, his opponent being accompanied to the ring by Damian Steele, he is Tim Rage.
The big monster, Tim Rage, looking to show that the Gathering still holds dominance here over Monday Night Raw, and with Zadlin in the title picture, who knows, maybe next season the Gathering will still reign supreme over Monday Night Raw.
Well, Tim Rage, just one person you don't want to meet in the back alley, just say that, or in dark alley even. Back alley, dark alley, same thing to me. Maz, you can talk, you know, it's alright, he's not going to come over here.
No, I'm just in awe of the size of this man. He is massive, and it's just, his presence in the ring is definitely something that you have to be here to witness.
Oh my goodness, here we go then, ladies and gentlemen. Tim Rage, Rob Dundee, Maz, who are you going for?
I'm going to have to go with Tim Rage, I think. The newcomer in Dundee is just not going to have the power to match up against the big Rage here tonight.
Let's see that. Oh, nice hip toss. Look at this. Rob Dundee will have the power. I've got no doubt about this. If anyone, you could see, we're talking about matchups early on. Rob Dundee seemed to have it all. He has the speed. He has the power. It just, something isn't clicking just for him just yet here on Raw, Maz. A fair point.
Yeah, I thought maybe last week would be his breakout opportunity to pick up the win and go on to face MVP for the United States Championship, but just wasn't able to get the job done.
And of course, Geordie on one side, and you've got Damian Steele on the other. Oh my goodness, just what a throw by Tim Rage. And again, who would have thought that Tim Rage would be busting out the wrestling moves early on here?
Going for a big power slam here.
Oh my goodness, the ring just shook, and somehow Dundee managing to come back, and well, Tim Rage ducks his head, and that is going to allow Dundee to hit the DDT. Now continuing to focus on the neck area here.
He's definitely looking to wear down Tim Rage and try and keep him grounded a little bit, start using some of his power maneuvers to weaken down this big monster.
And again, a lovely another hip toss by Dundee. Dundee trying to get back, and again just taking down Tim Rage, just again in control again here. And well, Dundee's going to have to try and keep away, try and use his speed here, because it looks like the power isn't working early on. Look out, another back suplex right on the back of the head.
This monster gets going, he's force to be reckoned with. He's looking to tear through Rob Dundee right now.
Oh, what a slam right there. And that could be it. Dundee is in a lot of trouble. You can see the back is in a lot of pain here. And now, oh, no, we're there. What's Tim Ridge thinking about doing here? Oh, look out. Oh, takes him down. The rack attack, you could call it, but that has got to be it.
And Jordy's up trying to distract the referee, trying to give Rob Dundee a chance to get back in this matchup, and looks like it worked out for the advantage here.
Look at this, dropping the knee down. Dundee lucky to get out of that one. You would have thought that if it wasn't for Jordy, that this match could have been over. Well, look at this, Tim Ridge again just cutting him off at the pass. And an up kick again. Now what the hell, Damien Steele?
Steele's trying to tell the referee to stop bothering with Jordy and watch the match, what was going on.
But this is give a great chance for Dundee here to come advantage into the Bulldog. Referee still distracted. And that maybe have hindered him. And ah, sidewalk slam! Cover! And again, Damien Steele, come on!
What's Damien's plan? What's he trying to get at? Why is he getting in the ring?
I don't know what it is. Maybe trying to see if he can get a sneak attack in here. And look at this! Oh my goodness, what a gut buster! How Jordy has not been told to leave ringside yet is beyond me!
How is Rob Dundee staying in this matchup? It's got to only be by Jordy saving him.
Two! Oh, come on, ref! This is ridiculous! And now Dundee's got the sleeper on!
Steele's up, yelling.
Jordy's been told to leave from inside.
Hey, referee's checking on this. Was that? Will Tim Ridge tap out?
Is Rob Dundee going to absolute steal one here? He is fading badly.
Not looking good.
The fans are checking. Tap, tap, tap. Somehow he's up. And look at this again. Steel up.
I think he knew if he didn't get up there that Rage was going to tap out and it was going to be end of this matchup. He's trying to save it.
Yeah, but Dundee let go of it. He knew even if he tapped, it wasn't going to make any difference. And look at this. Tim Ridge comes right now. He takes Rob Dundee's head off. And the referee. Oh, come on. Come on! Oh, come on! That's crazy!
It's just the outwitting and cunningness of Damien Steele. He was able to outwit Jordy on the outside, got him out of here, and was able to help Tim Ridge pick up the big win.
Ladies and gentlemen, the winner of this contest, Tim Ridge!
What will Season 4 hold for the Big Red Rage Monster? Will he conquer NSW Season 4, and will he become champion? I have to wait and see.
The worst thing is, with Damien Steele by his side, the sky's the limit for this man. Tim Ridge, a winner here tonight. Ladies and gentlemen, we are just 6 nights away from the end of Season 3. The biggest stage of them all, it's WrestleMania 3. As we know, 2 matches which will take place as of yet. Of course, we don't know who's going to be the tag team match because that's coming up next. But we're going to go through and talk about 2 of the matches we do know about, Maz. That start with the United States Championship MVP defending against the number one contender, Bobby Hall.
Yeah, this is definitely going to be quite the classic matchup between 2 of the great competitors and definitely 2 of the great technicians here in NSW. And hopefully MVP can hold back the attack of Bobby Hall and hold on to his championship.
MVP in action a little bit later on against Travis Soul. But Sunday night, it's all about the United States Championship against Bobby Hall. Who will walk out the champion? Talk about who will walk out the champion. One of these 4 men will end Season 3 as the World Heavyweight Champion as Matt Rhodes defends against AJ Z, Luke Benoit, and Zadlan Maz. It is due to be the biggest main event in Raw's history at WrestleMania.
Which one of these 4 competitors is going to have what it takes to outlast the other 3 competitors and end up winning that heavyweight championship and going into Season 4? It's going to be an uphill climb for the heavyweight champion and Matt Rhodes here in this matchup.
Find out what happens on Sunday night. Tournament Sunday night, who will face the Hounds? It'll either be the Flock or One Sec. It's coming up next on Raw.
We'll get to see One Sec get their rematch. Will they get to finally go against the Hounds again?
Ladies and gentlemen, introducing first, being accompanied to the ring by Luke Benward, the team of Daniel Cage, and JC Pullins, the Flock!
Yeah, but the Flock has definitely looked good as a team since coming under the tutelage of Luke Benward here in Monday Night Raw.
Since this group came together a few weeks ago, you have to say Luke Benoit has got a plan, and his plan may come to the front, Maz, on Sunday night. If he walks out the World Heavyweight Champion and the Flock leave as the Tag Team Champions.
It's very interesting to see if maybe the Flock will be running NSW Raw come season 4. If Luke Benoit can capture the Heavyweight Championship and his team here can win the number one contendership match and go on to face the Hounds and capture those tag team titles.
Yeah, you were still talking about the Gathering before, Maz, that the Flock are just have got just a bigger chance.
Yeah, well, see if they can put it together here tonight and take down this great tag team of Oliver Bisping.
Yeah, ladies and gentlemen, making their way to the ring, they're accompanied by Oliver Bisping, the team of Noki and Omega. One Sec!
These two massive Samoans looking to dominate the tag team landscape, and they held onto those tag teams as long as they could. The Hounds came back and were able to thwart them, so I'd love to see a great rematch between these two teams come WrestleMania.
Yeah, One Sec, led by Oliver Bisping, he has control over these two monsters. Who is going to be the number one contenders for the Hounds tag team titles? We will find out momentarily right here on Raw. Okay, here we go then. Maz, who are you going to go for in this one?
I'm going to have to go with One Sec. They just are so much more of a dominant tag team, and I don't know if the Flock will be able to withstand the power that these two guys bring to the ring.
Well, let's find out if the case. JC Pullins now in the ring. Takes Omega over. And you have to think, Maz, that face the Hounds on Sunday night, what is it going to take for the Flock to defeat One Sec here tonight?
They're going to have to use their speed and their agility to keep these two heavy Samoans off their feet and kind of keep the ring cut off so they stay on their side.
Well, look at this now. Double team! Oh, there's the elbow drop right into the back. And now, it's JC Pullins trying to work over Noki here. What would it mean for the Flock, though, Maz, to defeat One Sec here, to meet the Hounds? What would it mean to them to know that they could end with two lots of titles at the end of WrestleMania?
It'd be very interesting to see how Luke Benward would use that power of having the heavyweight title and the tag team champions all in his group, and would the Gathering pretty much be dissolved if that happens.
Now look at this, tag in, watch out, Cage flying, and now Noki could be in trouble. No, just as I say that though, Noki coming back, look out, oh, the Samoan roll, and that could do it, Maz, that could be it.
Yeah, Cage just got in there, but looks like Kevin King is not happy after losing his title.
Kevin King is done for season 3, ladies and gentlemen. Will we see him in season 4? Speculation runs wild of what will happen. Hopefully we will get some news in the off season if we will see Kevin King again.
And yeah, now looks like we got Pullins on the outside. Now Cage is locked on the submission, but he gets too close to the ropes, and now Bisping's up arguing with the referee.
And look at this one. Oh, nice by Noki, taking full advantage. Referee has to turn around here, but not seeing this. And maybe that's the difference between Bisping and Damian Steele. Damian Steele told the ref to turn around. Oliver Bisping still arguing with the referee, and that could have cost. One sec here. And now, all of a sudden, into the cover. Is this enough this time? No, kick out of two. More like a breakup at the count of two.
And Collins was able to watch out for that pinning fall there, and about to see if they kind of regroup here and maybe get the match back on their side.
Look out, and Megal on the top. Oh, into the cage bottom! Cage bottom! Surely, this is it! Pin him! Into the cover! But Bisping is up again!
The referee's got his hands full in this matchup right now and looking to try and figure out who's still a legal man and trying to get Bisping off the apron. Now it's like he's sending him back to the locker.
It's about time, but look at this, into the cover! This could have... No, Megal thought he had him here. Pulling raced back inside the ring. Cage looking to take advantage of it. No, again, double kicks again by Megal. And look at this now, up. Oh no, what the hell? Oh, planting! Cage, center of the ring! Oh no, 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 no! Oh, he sat on him! Two, and he...
Not getting up, going for the pin.
No, Pullins breaks up the count of two. Oh, and there's that big Samoan headbutt. Taking Cage off him.
Just dominating it. Yeah, Muggles just dominating this matchup now, taking control of Cage.
I don't think Cage has got much left in him here after that headbutt and then the slam. Nookie's took off JC Pullins, and that is three! And one sec is going to WrestleMania!
Wow, what a huge tag team matchup that's going to be when one sec gets to take on the Hounds again for the tag team titles. This would be, I think, the third matchup between these two guys, these two teams for the tag team titles, and it's going to be a great match.
Ladies and gentlemen, the winners of this contest, Omega and Noki, one sec!
Well, this is definitely making me look forward to what's going to happen at WrestleMania. I can't wait to see one sec and the Hounds go at it again.
It is going to happen, Maz. It'll happen at Sunday night at WrestleMania 3. Whoa, what the hell? Disney?
So we took out Mr. Disney.
Wow, what the hell is this all about? Well, it looks like Thomas Hall is going to have to come out by himself as he takes on the United States Champion MVP next on Raw.
Will Silas be able to put his mind into this matchup after knowing that Disney got taken out?
Well, we'll have to find out, because ladies and gentlemen, making his way to the ring, he is the only stylist for the Disney Alliance, Travis Soule.
Travis Soule strutting and cutting his way down to the ring, looking to pick up another big win. And what a great win it would be if he could knock off the U.S. champion in this matchup.
And indeed, Bobby Hull will be watching this match very closely, but the question is, who took out Joe Disney backstage?
Who knows? Disney has a lot of people that do not like him and would like to get their hands on him, so it could have been anybody.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, introducing Travis Soule's opponent. He is the United States champion, Marcus Van Patrick, MVP!
Yeah, what can we say about this guy? He's just been top-notch for NSW. He's won so many titles. It's a plethora of titles that you can list that he's held on to. And well, what a great U.S. champion he's been.
Let's go through it. Two-time NSW champion, European champion, three-time United States champion. This guy is indeed the MVP of NSW.
Yeah, well, we see him go on to season four with the U.S. title and continue on holding on to that championship.
It is big time coming up, ladies and gentlemen. The granddaddy of them all on Sunday night, WrestleMania, and MVP looking to once again steal the show. He course, he does not want to look past the stylist, Travis Searle, early in this contest. Maz, who are you going for?
I'm going to go with the champ, MVP. He's going to definitely not want to go into WrestleMania with a loss. So he's going to look to definitely show it off here against Travis Searle.
Well, let's have a look what the NSW app has to say. Thank you again, guys, for your votes. Keep it coming all night long. 74.6 for MVP, 25.4 for Travis Searle. And look at this, Travis Searle starting early on. But who did take Disney out? That's the question. Who would have took out that friendly, devious mouse?
Well, it could have been those hooligans from the beginning, the realest guys, Jabroni Diaz and X-Con.
Come on, why would they do it?
Well, after their big loss against the Ryan Fox and Killer Whale earlier tonight, maybe they have a grudge against Disney.
I think you have a grudge against them. That's the problem, Maz. As anyone, even the MVP, can do a Russian leg sweep.
Especially with style.
Well, that's true. Look out, taking Travis Searle down. NSW app, what do you think? Who do you think took out Joe Disney? Tell us who you think. We'll get it with some predictions. See what you. Let's see what Maz thinks of your predictions of who took out the mouse here tonight. As Travis Searle chopping down MVP. Somebody saying could it have been Oliver Bisping, but of course we've seen Oliver Bisping out here. With one sec, so I don't think it was him.
Might have been Damien Steele of The Gathering. Maybe he's trying to take out Disney to get to AJZ before the main event at WrestleMania.
A lot of people saying Bisping, but how could it have been Bisping?
Yeah, Bisping was out at the ring, so.
Just doesn't seem right with Travis Searle out here without Joe Disney, though.
Well, it's definitely not hindering him in his match right now. He's taking it right to MVP.
Anyone! Even the person who did the most in a Royal Rumble match can do a Russian leg sweep. Travis Kerr, another name out there. Travis Kerr hasn't been seen here tonight, of course. It could be Travis Kerr.
Another person. He wasn't out with Bobby Hall and Team Canada earlier tonight, so maybe it could have been Kerr.
AJZ, Kevin King. Kevin King's left. Kevin King's not here. Look at this MVP, though. Look at MVP. Look at the flip up here. Just the style of MVP. And look out, anyone, even the MVP, can do two Russian leg sweeps in one match.
Maybe he's trying to show up Travis Searle here, the master of the Russian leg sweep.
Yep, seven Russian leg sweeps in the Royal Rumble match. Of course, the record in any one match. I think that would be long, long a record. Oh, what a kick! Right to the back of the head! Talking about cutting and strutting, this could be it. No, just a one.
Travis Searle is definitely on his game here tonight, stepping it up against the U.S. champ. Just as I say that, he crashes and burns, and now MVP taking control of his matchup.
Look at this, in to the corner, and MVP waiting his turn again. Look out, into the ropes. MVP with the knees up, and then the drop kick, lovely by MVP. MVP feeling it here. Travis Searle could be in a lot of trouble with a forearm to the face. And now look at MVP sizing him up, one side of the ring to the other. Oh, right into the turnbuckle. And MVP in complete control now. Where's he going here? Yeah, Maz, where is MVP? MVP, hello, MVP. No, no. Thought about it. Thought about it again. And maybe just trying to play mind games with Travis Searle here, Maz.
Yeah, I don't know. Looks like MVP is definitely looking to take out our table here.
Yeah, it looked like he took a few times to get it on. Now, Travis Searle up. Oh, no, this is not good. I think we better move, Maz. Maz! Incoming!
He's looking to fly.
Oh my god! Well, that is why he's the MVP, I guess, Maz.
Yeah, posing right there for the crowd to take a little bit of a picture of the great work that he's done.
Look at this, back inside the ring. Nice drop kick. Could Travis somehow fight to make a comeback here? Needs to do one. MVP to the outside. And maybe that posing, Maz, has cost MVP here.
Yeah, it seems Travis is shaking off the effects of that table, getting run to the table. Now he's trying to fight back here and trying to take MVP out, but it's definitely going back and forth between these two.
Yeah, what a contest it has been between these two here tonight. Just 6 nights before MVP defends against Bobby Hall. Travis Hall giving it his best here. You've got to see what an effort by both these men, Maz.
Yeah, they're both looking to leave season 3 with a big win, and hopefully MVP can find a way to win this.
Playmaker! And that could be that. No, fighting spirit by the stylist.
But chop to the chest, looking to try and mount some kind of offense.
But that cut off just as when you thought there was time for Travis Hull to come back. The standing corkscrew and MVP, just like that, Maz, picks up the win.
Just showing you how good he can be, and hopefully he'll be that great come WrestleMania, and they'll be able to hold on to his US Championship.
Ladies and gentlemen, the winner of this contest, your United States Champion, MVP, Marcus Van Patrick.
What a win for MVP, and hopefully, like I said, he can do it at WrestleMania, and we'll see him in season 4 as a US champ, but he's going to have a tough test against Bobby Hall.
Well, you have to see, it is going to be a classic on Sunday night. MVP installing. Well, that is Bobby Hall. He wants that championship, Maz, and I'm sure it is going to be a classic come Sunday night.
Yeah, those two are going to definitely tear the house down when they get to the ring and fight for that US title.
It is going to happen, Maz. We now know 3 of the matches for Raw, of course. Some matches also you'll see at Mania, of course, on the pre-show. It is going to be the Vader Memorial Battle Royal. 2 from Raw, 2 from SmackDown, and 2 from ECW. Who will win? Check us out. 9:30 in the UK for the pre-show. But let's move on, Maz, for our main event. AJ Z and Luke Benoit will team just 6 nights away from their match, of course, with Matt Rhodes and Zadlan on the other team.
These 4 guys get along to fight through this tag team match. Who knows? We'll have to wait and see when this match gets started.
Ladies and gentlemen, introduce him first. He is AJ Z.
It's great to see the Z-Man back here in action, and what a great opportunity it's going to be for him to go into WrestleMania to fight for that heavyweight title, and will he be able to claim it?
And of course, it is just the ultimate prize on Raw here, Maz, the World Heavyweight Championship. AJ Z, all 4 men in this match have tasted the gold. You know that it is going to be a hell of a fatal 4-way elimination as well come Sunday night at WrestleMania. But tonight, you're right, can these men get along?
Can they put their differences aside for one night just to coexist here in this matchup to get the win? But we'll have to wait and see. I don't know. I don't even know if Benoit can team with anybody other than himself.
We're going to find out here tonight. AJ Z, as you see, no Disney with him for this one. Disney being taken to a local medical facility. We'll keep you. Hopefully, we'll get some news on that before the end of the show. But ladies and gentlemen, introducing Luke Benoit!
The Dark Prince. Smells of smoke and sulfur walking through the hell fires of hell to win this matchup here tonight. Maybe go on to WrestleMania and become heavyweight champion again.
The thing is, who would doubt Luke Benoit? Was, do you think his ego got the better of him as soon as he became World Heavyweight Champion, Maz?
Oh yeah, he definitely power went straight to his head, because after he lost it, he definitely went mental, and we saw how he attacked JC Pullins and Daniel Cage, and now has them working with him after they drank this horrible flu that he spits out here toward the crowd.
But that's the thing, Maz. That's the thing that many people said was, if he had just played in line with the Gathering, he may still be World Heavyweight Champion.
I think becoming World Champion definitely went right to his head, made him think that he should have been the leader of the Gathering, and definitely sent a rift between him and Zagling.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, their opponents, introduce him first. He is the World Heavyweight Champion, Matt Rhodes.
Matt's been able to hold on to that title for the past couple of weeks now due to the help of Zadlan, so we'll have to see if maybe him and Zadlan can finally get on the same page here tonight. Maybe pick up a big win.
If anything is to go by, I can tell you right now that it is not going to be this for the one of the... I was going to say the week of heart, but you know Zadlan and Matt Rhodes are not going to be friends.
Maybe the common enemy of AJZ and Luke Benward on the other side will help them kind of find an even ground to coexist here in this matchup for tonight.
Well, all I can say, ladies and gentlemen, is this is going to be a barn burner of a match, and we still have the monster Zadlan to come out. Here he comes, ladies and gentlemen. The last man of the contest, and Matt Rhodes' tag team partner, Zadlan!
The great phenom of NSW, known as Zadlan, looking to make his way down to the ring here tonight. Can he tag up with Matt, pick up the win over Luke Benward and AJZ? We'll have to find out as this match takes place.
Zadlan, the man. Many people have said, Matt, that Matt Rhodes doesn't respect him, Maz. Doesn't care about Zadlan. Could that be really one thing that fight that Matt Rhodes doesn't want to take here? Let Zadlan go after Luke Benoit. Maybe Matt Rhodes should concentrate on AJZ here.
Yeah, well, maybe we'll even see Matt kind of walk away from this match and let Zadlan face them two by himself. You never know. I mean, Matt's always wanting to hold on to that championship, and what an advantage it would be to leave this match early and be able to save yourself for the pay-per-view.
Anything is possible, ladies and gentlemen. Definitely in the world of NSW, and well, there's nothing more than seeing Zadlan come to the ring. Man that I would have to say doesn't demand but has earned respect of many people here in NSW, Maz.
Here we go. This is going to be a great matchup between four of the best here in NSW.
Well, let's see what Maz's prediction for our main event is.
I think I'm going to go with the champ. I think him and Zadlan just have the power advantage over the smaller two of AJZ and Luke Benward.
NSW are completely split, 50-50 on this one. I don't blame you, of course, just 6 nights away from WrestleMania. Who is going to get the upper hand, of course? And will it mean any upper hand, Maz? Does it mean that just because you win here tonight gives you that upper hand for WrestleMania?
Well, it definitely gives you a little bit of a momentum and a bit of a boost knowing that you're able to pick up the victory, so... Come WrestleMania, you may be the one that can pin all three of these guys and eliminate them, or even get the last pin to win the whole thing.
Nope. That's what I'm saying. Look at this. Oh! Early shot by Luke Benoit. Taking Matt Rhodes down here. And you have to say it. Definitely looking to try and get the advantage.
And keeping Matt over in his corner, over on their side of the ring there, looking to double team here with AJZ.
But that's what they've got to think. That's what they've got to do here. And Matt Rhodes now trying to get out. Zadlan walked away! Oh my god.
Looks like he's leaving the champ to fight this alone.
This might not be a good thing. This could all be a plan, ladies and gentlemen. That could come to look. Zadlan trying to get a shot in, but I think He hit both, and he knew he was hitting both there.
Hey, man, trying to fight back. Looking to take AJZ down here.
Whoa, whoa, whoa. What's going on here? These two meet on Sunday, Maz.
It looks like maybe he was trying to leave, and Bobby Hall wants to say a few things to him. And
oh, hold on, a sucker punch! Ah, here we go!
A little bit of that hardcore style from Bobby Hall again coming out of him.
But why? Why not wait till Sunday? You've sort of got a psychological advantage. Why do this? Why try and do this just a few nights before WrestleMania?
Just Bobby Hall wants to get his chance and wants to get his hands on MVP and maybe get an upper, a little bit of an upper hand or a little bit of an advantage.
Zadlan taken off by AJZ, and AJZ now looking to get Luke Benoit back in the contest. As you see, oh, nice takedown. Of course, well, I gotta say, it's going to be an all-out brawl between Bobby Hall and MVP, and well, these four men still going at it here. Into the cover.
Jay-Z taking out Zadlan again.
No, but just a two. Zadlan even taking out as Matt Rhodes can kick out here. Benoit, look at Benoit. Oh, nice whisper in the wind. Benoit shot.
Able to connect to Matt's head there. Looks like Matt's got the fighting spirit now.
Yeah, that's what he needs here. Matt Rhodes, look out. Nice knee right into the jaw. And now trying to take Zadlan to the outside. No, sorry, Luke Benoit to the outside, knocking Benoit down. Zadlan, of course, on the outside there. You can see Zadlan just pacing backwards and forwards. I thought Zadlan would have been going after Luke Benoit there, but has Zadlan got a plan here?
It seems he's keeping his distance. I don't know why.
And look at there's a bit of a collision there. AJZ now tagged back in and ducking under Matt Rhodes. AJZ in the wrong corner here. This is who needs to get Matt Rhodes out of there. Oh, and the backdrop taking Matt Rhodes down.
And this, Matt was kind of telling Zadlan get into this matchup here and kind of distracted him. Now he's giving AJZ the upper hand in this match.
Oh, but look at that. Went for the people's knee and Zadlan cut him off. Maybe that could have helped Matt Rhodes there. But look at this. AJZ tying with Matt Rhodes here.
Yeah, well, this be the last two in the main event at WrestleMania for the Raw Heavyweight title. Will this be who's there, or will it be Matt and Zadlan?
Look at this. Oh, classic tag team move. Who would have thought these two doing this? And Zadlan, oh my goodness, Zadlan calling for the end. And oh, one hand. Look at AJZ, you're going for the ride. Into the cover. The referee down. Is this enough? Yes, it is! The team of Zadlan and Matt Rhodes pick up the winning of tonight's main event!
Matt was able to stop Benoit from getting in the ring, and Zadlan picked up the big win, and will he do that at WrestleMania and become heavyweight champion? These two are definitely not going to want to look... wait.
What? What? What?
This definitely added some more speculation into WrestleMania. Is Matt part of the gathering?
Has Matt done the unthinkable? Who would have thought these two would have been celebrating as Raw goes off the air? Ladies and gentlemen, that is it. The final Raw is over for season 3. It's a big thank you, of course, for Mass Freeway, who's been here from most of it. In fact, about 99%. Maz, we look forward now to Sunday night. Are you ready?
I can't wait. WrestleMania is right around the corner. Just 6 days away. It's going to be a great night of action.
That is it, ladies and gentlemen. Thanks for watching. Dave Easton and Maz Rhea. Thanks for watching. We'll see you tomorrow night for the final episode of Total Divas for Season 3. Thanks for watching. Good night.